Hello guys, this is Alois Oz. I am doing these videos because I've had way too many people ask me, how do I do my Photoshop stuff? And when I try to explain it, they sort of kind of get confused, and half the time I don't know how to explain it. So I'm gonna try and show you guys. I already got my stuff on the right bottom corner, like the clothes, the skin, the hair, stuff like that already synced out. But, because if you don't know how to do layers yet, I can't help you there. Alright, what I always like to do, I always like to start with the skin. It's actually pretty easy when you're doing it because, a lot of the time, it's better to do the skin first than the hair, than the eyes and the clothes, stuff like that, because then it will kind of blend more together, if depending on if you mess up or not. And what a lot of people didn't really tell me on the lasso tool, you need to use this one because it's a lot easier. And you need to keep it to where you can add more layers, I mean, more sections to it, and so you're not like doing one piece at a time. Because no one told me that. I had to figure it out. But, I mean, it's a lot easier. To me, it is. A lot of people freehand it and just like use the brush and color it and whatever else. It is a lot easier on some pictures, but for me, it's not. But, it's not really much. I will start saying what I'm doing to where a lot of people don't know, but a lot of you know what to do on the first start. It's just a lot of people don't know exactly how to do it. It's like backgrounds. I've had way too many people tell me, how do you do the backgrounds? How do you get rid of the backgrounds? It's so hard to explain because if you're like this, it's really hard to do it. But it's like when I go below here and start adding it down where the numbers and stuff is, a lot of people don't know what that's called, and I try to explain it, and it's really hard trying to explain something that you don't know what it's called. So you have to show them, but when you got nothing to show for it, it's kind of hard. For right now, I might just do a video of the skin for almost all of them. I might not do anything complicated to where people will actually know what to do, and it's to where they're not asking me more questions. How do you do this? How do you do that? Where do you go and get this stuff? No. I'm not going to be able to do that. You want to know where you get patterns, you go to google.com, search up patterns, Photoshop, there you go. I hate that my mouse is so sensitive. It always mistakes me for double clicking, and I don't double click. That was also one thing that I am willing to do, because I know a lot of people, they can't afford Photoshop. I couldn't afford Photoshop. Do not ask where I got this Photoshop. Don't, because I'm not going to get arrested for anything because my friend helped me get it. I know a lot of people have GIMP, and they kind of wonder how to use it a lot. If people are wanting, I will start making GIMP videos. I do have GIMP, so it's not like it's gonna be a big deal for me to teach people because a lot of people don't know how to use the background stuff like I do on there. And a lot of people ask me about it, and I'm like, I'd have to show you sometime. I don't really know. I mean, I could have done a video for it, but I never had time. I never had a computer. I was never alone. I never had a computer headset, so that's why I'm doing it now. since I'm using my kind of Guardian's headset, since it actually works. But it's actually a lot of work. On some of my edits, a lot of people, they really, really like them, and I'm really glad. I love comments on my photos because it actually makes me feel better, and I actually start doing a lot more, which that's one of the reasons why I don't do them that much, is because I think they suck, and they actually apparently don't. But I mean, there's a lot of people I want to teach that I was wanting them to teach me about Photoshop because it was really cool with the way they did their stuff. But come on, you can't keep giving your secrets away to people. I know that. There's just so much you can teach them, and then the rest you're like, oh, I'm gonna save that for me. But yeah, this takes a long time. If you do freehand, it's actually kind of faster. But the reason why I do this is 'cause I'm used to shading. I do shade by myself. I don't use the burn tool. I don't do that other stuff. I do this and then I'll select a skin color and then start doing it. And whatever else. 'Cause I don't really like doing freehand because it just messes with the computer a little bit too much. Well, I can't say the computer, the picture, because I don't like doing all the erasing stuff. I try to do as little as possible, even though it looks like I do a lot with my pictures some of the time, and I do because I'm trying to make it look good. Half the time I kinda try a little too hard, but don't be afraid to try something. If you find something on the internet and you're like, oh, I need to try that, then try it. Don't be just like, well, I'm not gonna be good at it, so I'm not gonna do it. Don't do that. 'Cause then you're never gonna get good at it. Because you have to try new things. You can't just stick to the old stuff. Okay, this freaking mouse is starting to piss me off. It's not wanting me to select anything, apparently. Alright, there we go. Bad thing is, it just started happening recently. Like I said, I know this is taking forever, and since there's three people, I'm only gonna do one person, and then probably, like, can't s do re stop the video or something, or start, like, doing his hair and stuff. I'm just gonna work on one person. And then, I might start doing more complicated stuff with the other two, since there's three people in here, and I kinda wanna teach people as much as I can. Even though I'm not that good of a teacher. But I do know how hard it is and stuff to learn this on your own, so I've had to learn everything on my own. I had to learn GIMP a lot on my own, except for a couple of friends helping me. But other than that, not really. But I know a lot of people don't like using GIMP. I do. Some of the stuff I think it's actually a lot easier. But some of the stuff it's not because I'm so used to Photoshop now. And seriously, don't be commenting or anything asking, oh, where'd you get the Photoshop? Where'd you get the Photoshop? The place where I got the Photoshop at, it no longer exists because of that SOPA stuff that passed. They didn't wanna get in trouble, so they had to shut their stuff down. So, 'cause I didn't have $300 to fucking pay for it. Oh, excuse my language. I'm so used to saying stuff like that. Alright, well, we got this done. What I should have done, because I don't like using pictures like these because of the way, like, it's all gray and stuff. You go to picture mode, you go to grayscale. Don't flatten the image if you have your stuff. Just discard it, it'll turn black and white. I found it a lot easier to do black and white, and then you turn it back to RGB color, do not flatten, and to where you can color it. Alright, that's also one thing I was wanting to show you, because these characters, I don't know who I'm editing. I'm just randomly editing. This is how I come up with new characters. I just randomly edit, think like 2 seconds, and then start making them. I think I'm gonna do a redskin dude. I haven't made one. I haven't made them in a while. All right. You're here. You select what color you want. Usually, depending on what you're editing, I like doing multiply because it makes it look a little bit better. Sometimes. Sometimes it don't. Sometimes it does. But yeah. As you zoom in, make sure you got all of it first. See, I missed the spot. See, I would have seen that if I was still far away. I have no idea why that spot kept being that way. But you switch over to a less denser one. You choose maybe a darker color. Don't usually choose these because sometimes they're way too dark and sometimes they're way too light. So I kind of like making them myself and kind of trying them. Yeah, see, that's a good one. All right, then you go start shading. Shade everything that you possibly would think that you would see shaded, like on a human, on the regular people. Yeah, right down there, kind of shade a little up there, and then it's one of the reasons why I like some of these kind of pictures because they already got the shading on it, so you just have to kind of follow it. You just have to make it a little more darker, make it more kind of realistic almost. Oops. All right, back up. All right, then we go down here.